In this video, we're computing the moment of inertia of a rectangular slab, actually about two different axes. And the first one we're going to do is when the rotation axis is collinear with one edge of the slab, as shown in the picture below. Now, the second problem we're going to solve is an axis parallel to one edge of the slab, but passing through the center of mass. And as you can imagine, the methods to solve that are very closely related to the first problem. So we're told in this first problem, where we're rotating the slab about one edge, we're told that we can use this previous result for the moment of inertia of a rod rotating about one end. And so the idea here is to slice our rectangular slab into a bunch of thin rods. Then we're going to use this old formula to figure out the moment of inertia contribution of each of those thin rods. And then we're going to use an integral to add all those up and find the total moment of inertia of the rectangular slab. Now notice that I did a lot of labeling in the diagram when I popped that thin slice of the rectangular slab into the picture. We're going to call the mass of it dm because it's an infinitesimal mass. The side lengths of our rectangular slab are a for the width and b for the height. So the length of our thin slice is also a. And we're indicating the vertical position of this slice as a variable quantity y that goes all the way from 0 at the bottom of the slab to b at the top. And the thickness of the slice we're going to call dy. Now, before we go about setting up the moment of inertia integral, we need a quick note on the idea of area density. So area density is usually given the Greek letter sigma. And that's just the mass of an object divided by how much area is taken up by that object, where we're viewing the object as being two-dimensional, or at least uniformly thin. So we could find the area density of this entire rectangular slab by taking the mass and dividing by the total area. And in fact, we're going to use that formula at the end of this problem. What I want to do for now is turn this around. So we can say the total mass of a laminate or a thin object is given by this area density multiplied by the area. But this also applies to an infinitesimal mass taking up an infinitesimal amount of area. So our little mass dm for this slice could be written as sigma times dA, the area density times the incremental area of that slice. So now we can start making progress on setting up our integral. I can get some more details about dm. And so we write dm equals sigma times dA, but the area dA is just length times width for that little slice, and that's little a times dy. Now we can take that little dm and sub it into the formula for the moment of inertia of a rod rotated about one end, because after all, that's what this little slice is doing. And that gives us a moment of inertia contribution to the total moment of inertia of the slab. So that's 1/3 times the mass, which I'm just going to call dm for the moment, times the length of the rod squared, and that's a. So I have a squared. So we sub in our dm, and that's sigma a dy. And now we simplify our moment of inertia increment di to 1/3 sigma a cubed dy. So now that we have the moment of inertia contribution of a single thin rod slice of this thing written down, we can add up all the contributions by using an integral. So first we're going to write that I, the total moment of inertia of this slab about one edge, is given by the sum of all the di contributions. And that's the essence of physical integration. An integral adds up all these infinitesimal contributions, and we sub in our formula for di, again, 1/3 sigma a cubed dy, and we're adding all these up as we go from the bottom of the slab to the top. So this is an integral from 0 to b. Now everything in that integrand is constants except for the dy. So we're just integrating dy, and that gives us y, and we're evaluating from 0 to b. Subbing in the lower limit there would give us 0. So really we're just looking at 1/3 sigma a cubed times b. Now that is the moment of inertia of this rectangular slab about one edge, but we don't want to express our final answer in terms of the area density. We want our final answer in terms of the total mass of the slab. So we go back to our definition of area density, and we say, well, the area density can be replaced with a big M divided by the area of the slab, which is little a times little b. So making this replacement, we end up with 1/3 times big M over ab, times a cubed times b. And the b's cancel, and one of the a's cancels, and we end up with this formula for the moment of inertia of a rectangular slab about one edge as 1/3 m a squared. And we notice this is precisely the same formula as we got for the moment of inertia of a rod rotated about one end, and this isn't a coincidence. In a sense, a rectangular slab being rotated about one edge is just a rod being rotated about one edge. just smeared out through a second dimension. In other words, we still have the same percentage of all the mass at the same distances from the rotation axis as we do for a simple one-dimensional rod. So it's not a surprise that we got the same formula, 1/3 ma squared. Okay, next we're going to look at this closely related problem of a rectangular slab being rotated about an axis parallel to one edge but passing through the center of mass. And basically everything's going to happen the same for this problem, except now we're asked to use the known formula for the moment of inertia of a rod rotated about its center of mass, which is 1/12 ml squared. So we can go back to that sort of physical intuitive idea that I was just talking about at the end of the last problem and say, well, this is really just the same distribution of mass relative to the rotation axis as a one-dimensional rod rotating about its center. And we're going to expect to get 1/12 ma squared for the result here. But let's go ahead and see how the details work out. So we're going to slice this thing into thin rods. That looks very much like the last problem. We have a thin rod of a mass dm and a length of a at a height of y. Its thickness is dy. And again, we use the concept of area density here to write that dm is sigma dA. But dA is the length times width for that little slice, so I end up with sigma a dy. This allows us to write down the moment of inertia contribution of this single rod, which is being rotated about its center. So it has a moment of inertia contribution of 1/12 times dm times a squared. Then we sub in dm and get sigma a dy in there. And we have 1/12 times sigma a dy times a squared. And so we end up with this moment of inertia contribution of 1/12 sigma a cubed dy. And then we use an integral to add all these up. And we're going to add these up as y goes from 0 to b. Again, slicing this thing into thin rods all the way from the bottom of the slab to the top. And our antiderivative is just 1/12 sigma a cubed times y. We evaluate from 0 to b. And we end up with a moment of inertia of 1/12 sigma a cubed times b. And then we want to replace the area density with its definition in terms of the total mass of the slab, which is big M, and the total area of the slab, which is the product of length and width, or little a times little b. And again, the b's cancel, so the height of the slab doesn't matter. One factor of a cancels, and I end up with what I expect to get here, a 1/12 m times a squared. And again, that's not too surprising because we still have the same percentage of all the mass at all the same distances from the rotation axis as we do for a one-dimensional rod rotating about its center. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.